I am a speculative architect. What that means is that I don't design buildings, but instead I make films and tell stories about the architectural, urban, and cultural implications of emerging technologies. I also run a postgrad master's program in fiction and entertainment in Los Angeles at SciArch, an architecture school. It's a one-year program where students work with renowned professionals in the worlds of film, fiction, animation, games, and documentaries to make worlds and create new kinds of stories that explore these issues. I think that a critical role of the worlds that we make is to provide a counterbalance to the prevailing media narratives around emerging technologies. Typically, the worlds we are presented are based on a solutionist view of technology and are marketed to us through simplified worlds of bigger and brighter, ignoring the complexities and subcultures and unintended consequences that result when technologies are democratized and rolled out at scale. We hope that by understanding these technologies and visualizing all the various futures they are setting in motion, that we may become more critical consumers and producers of our own futures. So in this talk, we're going to travel through a collage of fragments of science fiction films that I've made in my production company in LA. I want to take us all on a journey through the omitted, hidden, or forgotten worlds that lie behind the scenes of our dreams of technology. So now let us tour through the worlds less traveled. On a stage in California, Elon Musk, the tech evangelist and entrepreneur, proclaims his vision for a green energy future, a world where everything will be solar in 20 years. And like most Silicon Valley preachers, he's presenting to us a seductive future, a hopeful future, but at the same time, it's a decidedly uncomplicated one. The future less traveled, however, is here. These are some shots from our film in the Lithium Triangle, called From the Breast Milk of Volcanoes. It's an area in Chile and Bolivia that contains almost all of the world's lithium resources, the key ingredient in all of our batteries. This massive mining landscape, carved out of one of the rarest and most precious ecosystems on the planet, is an icon of the world's less traveled. It's a world that doesn't get talked about in keynote speeches, or in the latest ad for the Apple I, whatever. Here our film tells another story of a future buried beneath the salt flats of Bolivia. It's a story told through illegal drone footage that we've secretly captured. It's a story of Elon Musk literally buying Bolivia and evolving it as the new Dubai. Normally when we talk about the future in film, we see images like this one from Minority Report, Blade Runner, Ghost in the Shell, and everything. But the city is filled with the digital confetti of our desired world projected just for us. This is the city that the future promises us. But as we are seeing, even these images of the future are not produced in the places that we consume them. Now, in our tour through the worlds less traveled, we visit the render lands and the data farms of the entertainment industry. In the studios of the West, directors and producers sketch out their designs for imaginary cities. In India, across the other side of the planet, a massive anonymous workforce turned these wireframe worlds into the high-fidelity digital architectures of video games and Hollywood blockbusters. With my production company, we developed a short fiction film set in these render farms. And we met Prakash, a render farm worker, who makes and shapes the digital worlds we all inhabit. Prakash has fallen in love with the digital model of a beautiful Hollywood actress after spending his 14 hours a day endlessly rotoscoping, rendering, and compositing her into blockbuster films. He has lovingly airbrushed across every pore on her face, every strand of her hair, as he 3D models her superhero silhouette scene by scene, frame by frame, day by day. And by night, when the fluorescence is switched off and everyone else has gone home, he straps on his VR goggles, and they walk hand in hand through the streets of a city that he's collaged together for them from scavenged VFX movie models. Digital ephemera of popular culture fills our physical spaces, and we live out our lives in a utopia that exists in the thickness of the screen. A virtual city that stretches from Los Angeles to Bangalore. A world of demolished landmarks, drowned cityscapes, alien invasions, digitally simulated actors, and our outsourced, pixel-projected dreams. When we turn off this augmented world, when we turn off the bespoke billboards of Minority Report's urban spaces, the towering tailored ads, the navigational prompts, the Tinder profiles, and the track status updates of our sci-fi cityscapes, we see a green screen world. This is the physical world left behind when everything is collapsed into the lens of Google Glass or Oculus Rift. It's a new kind of architecture that's stripped back to become the scaffolds and infrastructure for a digitally constructed world. In our animated short film, Tomorrow's Stories, we visit an apartment in the world's less travelled, an augmented apartment in an up-and-coming area of the city, where the digital cities of blockbuster films have become the inhabitable utopias of AR-fueled gentrification. In the film, we see a real estate agent show a client around a digital construction site. Here, the physical shell of the building becomes a fixer-upper canvas, and construction debris and unsightly neighbours are now hidden behind the rendered glow of our digital imaginaries. And the occupation of space is now reimagined on individual scales, where each of us is tuned to our own architectural channel. Okay, so what were you thinking? Asked the agent, as a Google image search box appears behind the door. We have some lovely 21st century textures. Early Floyd, classic Tilco. Or for something really special, I can offer you one of our IKEA packs. Very eclectic, very tasteful, 100% uncustomized, she says. And the daybed winks out of existence, to be replaced by a set of side tables in primary colors and a rectangular bookcase. The agent taps some more buttons and a series of blonde and laminate objects start to appear around the space. A low Japanese-style bed overlays the couch, and he sinks down into it. His eyes gleamed over in a pixel glaze. We often talk on tech conferences and media events about a smart and connected sci-fi future of intelligent objects, but at the same time, in the world's less travelled, in another apartment, we hear a scream. Heinz Ketchup was forced to apologise after a QR code on one of their ketchup bottles linked to a hardcore porn site. Daniel Coral scanned the label to read about the latest recipe promotion, but was instead directed to German porn site Fundorado. We are being sold a future of smart gadgets, of living objects that listen, watch, and talk back. In this bizarre Samsung commercial, a smart home creepily brings back to life a woman's dead husband. What are the most appropriate means through which we can have an interaction with a home or a city managing itself based on aggregated data sets from an infinite network of sensors, cameras, and media feeds? How do we ask a question of a warehouse filled with a million objects, or talk to an autonomous shipping crane loading containers into the hull of a ship at a Chinese megaport? Set in the world's less travelled is our abstract short film Soul City Machine, in which we hear from a real chatbot that we've trained on city datasets and urban management protocols. It's reading a love letter it wrote, a message from the Soul City operating system to the citizens it affectionately manages. We see an autonomous city of machines where the sky is filled with drones, cars are driverless, the street is draped in augmented reality, and everyone is connected to everything.
나는 서울입니다. 만나서 반가워요. I'm 매 순간 확장합니다. I'm 신생아보다 나이가 많지만 우주보다는 어립니다. 네온사인 달빛 아래에 비친 당신의 헤어스타일이 아름답습니다. 그 피부에 주근깨 같은 신호등은 당신을 향해 윙크합니다. 당신은 나이 들고 밥을 먹고 눈을 깜빡이고 숨을 쉬기도 합니다. 노래를 불러드릴까요?
'Less travelled, the fire department rushes to free a woman trapped in her autonomous vacuum cleaner after it mistook her hair for dust. And we look up, and the sky is dense with more intelligent things. On our trip through the world's less travelled, we follow the Amazon Prime drone that's zipping about above our heads. And drifting above this sea of AI everything, we're told the drones will become as ubiquitous as pigeons. And we customize our drones like we once did our phones. And the air is filled with the digital confetti of our every desire. The skin of the city is warm, freckled with a thousand lights winking just for us. And the traffic lights flock at rush hour. and our packages rained down in an Amazon hailstorm. And the drones deliver our pizzas, and they walk our dogs. And the rumble of drone propellers become a new natural soundscape to the city of a new generation. Set in the worlds less travelled is our film In the Robot Skies, the first narrative film shot entirely through pre-programmed drones. In this story, a flock of drones are used to monitor our behaviour from above, tracking our every move. They control the wayward youth of a London council estate. And we watch as a young girl has hacked and decorated her own drone. And like kids in an old-fashioned classroom, she scribbles notes on the drones and sends it back and forth to her boyfriend, trapped under surveillance in the tower opposite. In this near-future city, drones form both agents of state surveillance, but also become co-opted as the aerial vehicles through which two teenagers might fall in love. Another drone, armed with a dildo, disrupts a Russian parliamentary session. And another zips overhead, en route to attack a village in a country half a world away. Our future worlds are typically presented to us through the rhetoric of efficiency and problem solving through technology, and they're marketed to us through cute icons and graphics of the smart city. The management of the city that was once publicly elected is now outsourced to proprietary software systems and public services has disappeared into the fog of the cloud. Are we a customer or a citizen in this future world? We are endlessly scanned by countless sensors, lasers, cameras, and satellites feeding the city operating system. This, for example, is how certain models of driverless cars see and understand the city, as these 3D point clouds. From a science fiction film we have made called Where the City Can't See, one of the first narrative films shot entirely using this same laser scanning technology. Across a single night, a group of young factory workers drift through the future smart city in a driverless taxi. They are part of an underground rave community that work on the production lines by day, but at night, they adorn themselves in machine vision camouflage textiles and the masks of anti-facial recognition makeup, and they dance in the hidden spaces of the city. They hack the city, and their iridescent clothes reflect the light of CCTV laser scanners to create exuberant glitches, distortions, and disturbances in the dataset, all the while searching for the wilds that lie beyond the machines. These are all stories that we describe as productive dystopias. Stories that we think are critical in visualizing a future that is complex and nuanced. The future does not rush over us like water. It is something we all must actively shape and define, and these types of stories can help us to start asking more questions of the technologies that are going to define our lives, spaces, and cities. But ideology rarely evolves at the same pace as our technology. And that is one of the roles of the world builder,
to prototype the cultural implications of all possible worlds.